I built this GPT Excel tutor in a few minutes, and I want to show you how to use it and how to build your own. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. It's great to have you here. Now, I built this, as I said, this GPT in a matter of few minutes using the new builder, GPT. You do need to have the plus for this, so ChatGPT Plus, it's the paid for version. You can't do this in the free version. And this right here, so even the graphic here was created within the GPT builder. So that's part of it. And I actually changed it a few different times, and it's created through DALL-E 3 and it generated more and more. And I can easily change the things as I go along and go back and edit this if I want. Now, looking here, I have a few prompts that I can quickly start with. So you can adjust these prompts to be what you want. You could write your own, or it will suggest which ones to go with. And I also have it here that you can have your prompt. Let's do a little test run. Just to let you know, I'll have the link to this GPT down in my description here. If you have ChatGPT Plus, you can click on it and give it a try and see what you think. Test it out for me and let me know in the comments, did it work, what you're looking for, should it be tweaked? I'd like to know those things. This is new to me building these. Now, let's go ahead and just click on one of the prompts. How can I create a basic formula in Excel? So it went through, created this kind of step-by-step how to do this, select a cell, start with an equal sign, enter the formula, press enter. So I like this step-by-step. This is very good for beginners. Gives me an example how it would look. Now it even goes to that next step, because this first part, they're just starting it kind of like a calculator, but then they talk about cell referencing, and I could prompt it to go more into cell referencing and give me another example, but I'm not going to do that in this video. But go ahead and test it out if you're trying it on your own with the link down below in the description. Let's go back here. I'm just going to click here and I'm going to go new chat. The one thing I just want to point out, I could keep asking questions and it will be, so if I follow this up and go to another one, it will remember what's created before. You have that option when you create your GPT, whether you want that each prompt brand new, or do you want it to remember as it goes forward. So I am just going to go back to new chat. I just want to show you one more example. I was hoping when I created this that I'd be able to upload a spreadsheet for this, but it's not available yet. So I have the attachment here and it won't get the data that way. But if I go ahead and this time I'm going to just ask it a question to what chart. So I'm going to say, what chart will be best for the following data? Okay, so I'm going to go to Excel now and I have just a spreadsheet open and I'm going to take this information right here and I'm going to copy Control C and go back over here, and I'm just going to go Control V. So it's right in here with the information, and I'm going to hit enter, and let's see what it comes back with. It came back with 7 different charts that I could use and why I would use each of them, how it would be good for this. But now the next thing I could ask it, and I'm not going to, but I could give me a step-by-step how to do this. I like that it can break down the step-by-step and it'll give you examples when you can to, you know, to put it back into the cells. Now let's go back one more time here to new chat. So this is kind of the basics of this. It's kind of geared towards Excel basics. How do you create your own? Before I just start creating, I want to point out, if I go back up to here in the dropdown, I can edit this GPT here. I can copy the link, and this is what I'm going to put down in the description right from this point. When you click on it, you can access it if you have the ChatGPT Plus. I'm going to open the sidebar here. You can see the one that I already created here. I'm going to click on Explore. At this point, all I need to do is click Create a GPT, the beta here. And it's pretty much asked me, what do I want to create here? So I'm going to put in something I already have planned. So I want to build a GPT to help me bring the appropriate items on vacation. And I'm just going to start with send the message and we'll see what it comes back with. It seemed to like this idea, the GPT we're building will be a vacation packing assistant. I like that idea. What about a name? And it suggested a name, Travel Tidier. I like that. That's catchy. I could actually suggest Can you give me more options, like 5 more, just like normal ChatGPT? On the right-hand side, I'm getting a preview here with prompts, just like I showed you in the Excel one. What should I pack for a beach holiday, preparing for a business trip in Tokyo? These can be all modified. I'll show you that. But I'm going to say, I like this name. So I'll just say, I like it. And it's going to go to the next step. It's made me my logo for this GPT here. Do I like it or not? I can ask it to make more if I would like. I'll say I like it for this case, but I can always go back and change it later. I'll show you how to do that. It's already updated over here in the preview. So I'm going to just say I like it again. So the GPT builder went through, kept on building. At different points, it was asking questions that I could specify if I wanted to through it. I left it and let it kind of go through what it kind of thought. I let it have the conversation with itself, but I could have added information if I knew exactly what I wanted with this travel tidier GPT. I could go through and do that. But let's say I wanted to go to configure here. This is how I can reset things or change things. So if I hit configure through here, we have our travel tidier. I can change the name through here. Detailed and practical vacation packing guide. Here it is over here. Instructions. It wrote the instructions here for me. Conversation starters. Now I can exit any of these. I can close them off. And then I could write another one if I want it my own through there. You can see that there's upload files. And again, I'm not sure how that's working out yet, because when I did test it, it didn't work out quite great for me on the Excel one. And we can add actions. I'm going to leave this all the same, and I'm going to go ahead and just save. So when we save it, we have some options. I'm going to share this one with you down below in the description too. And that's why I'm just going to go only people with the link. I could go only me, or I could go public. And I'm just going to go ahead and hit confirm. If you go to the public, you need the builder part. So to make your GPT public, set up builder profile. I haven't done that yet. I'm just using these links to share with you and to show you how it works to test these out. So here we go. I have it all completed right here. I can close my side if I wanted to, and I have the travel tidier or detailed practical vacation packing guide. Again, I'll put the link down below. Let's see if I click one of these, what it will say. Well, I must say this will actually come in handy. It gives me that nice checklist that I could go through before I left, so I didn't forget anything. I'm going to have to play around with this a little bit more. Again, you play around with this too and let me know. So I hope you like this little tutorial on how to use GPT Builder to create these GPTs. Let me know how it works for you if you built any great ones yourself. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.